Hello, let's look at the beautiful sight, the station over there, this station, the sun, our ship. Now, you are not here to save the humans from the demons. You're actually here to save the demons from the humans because the humans are so much stronger than the demons right now. The demons will actually get destroyed every time they appear unless they are actually on about 600 quasimorphoses. Now, if you watch my other videos, you can kind of guide yourself with them as well because nothing much has changed, but the game went from being a straight line marathon to being kind of like a zigzag of avoiding bullets. Yes, it's exactly as fun as it sounds. You have to zigzag your way to victory because they have changed a lot of things, but essentially the game is the same. The most important thing is that you cannot advance as fast as you used to do. So let's get started with the corporations. What are the best corporations? The best corporations are still the same, with the exception of a few of them that will actually be a little better later on. So if you want to play the game at a very high rate, I recommend your first choice of corporation to help as much as you can. By the way, you should only do missions that have a basic of 2 skulls. If they have 3 skulls, be very careful. Defense missions are the hardest missions in the game right now because you don't have any big guns to kill the enemies. So don't do defense missions. Don't do any missions above 2 skulls. If you want to do a 3-skull mission, make sure it's going to be an easy one. Make sure you have a lot of equipment. Make sure it's not going to be on a planet that has a lot of quasimorphoses adding up. Make sure you are not facing a corporation that is rising. For example, if you have a mission with 3 skulls and you have to face French Comte, I don't recommend it, especially on the moon. The moon is one of the hardest locations right now just because the demons are so unpredictable right now. Venus you can handle, Mercury you can handle, but the moon, no, not the moon. So you have to do missions and be allied with RealWear just because of their great backpacks. They're amazing and they also have a lot of other cool things. Sadly, the grenades and the mines are not as useful, but they have some utility. They can also give you the veteran vest, which is kind of amazing. Look at all of that resistance against blunt, pierce, fire, and beam as well. But they have the best backpack, the best vest, and they also have a good chance of giving you a mine chip, a class chip, and also a basic item chip. Plus, their weapons will be a little more useful a bit later, but who wants a sword? No one wants a sword. I think the sword is the only problem that I have with all of this stuff. The submachine gun, the Mantis, is actually quite nice right now. Yeah, very useful. The next corporation you should be doing missions is ENCOM. ENCOM has actually a lot of good things. So, as you can see, this is at 4 tech points, but they only have one type of armor set, which is the Commando, which is basically like paper. But ENCOM does gain another set of armor. The Arbiter set of armor is actually very good against most of the physical attacks in the beginning, but later they gain the Shadow Pattern, which is only good against elemental damage, as you can see. But if you mix and match the, let's say, the Arbiter to, let's say, the helmet, and the armor will be from the Arbiter, and then you just have maybe the boots and the pants from this one, the Shadow, you actually create a suit of armor that will be super strong against most attacks. Well, I say super strong, it will be medium against most attacks, but you're going to be killed more by effects than normal damage this game. Again, it depends on how you play the game, you'll see what I mean. But they also give you access to the rookies, which are quite nice because they have a free size, the vests with free size, and also reload duration reduced, plus the fighter backpacks, plus basic item chips, also Taiga M. And keep in mind that the Taiga NCM is a lot better. I'm not sure what its capacity is right now. I haven't gotten one, but it's a little better than the Jeff Hammer. I think the Scatter is a little worse. No, it's more or less the same. 5 to 13. 14. Yeah, look at that. They have buffed the damage of the Taiga NCM, so it's kind of like an improved Jeff Hammer at this point. Plus, you also get the Storm NCM at some point. And this is a massive 9mm weapon that can delete enemies very fast. Also, you'll get another sword. Why are you giving me swords? Who wants to fight in space? Are we going to... We have vibroblades to fight the Jedi or what's the deal? I don't know. And then the third faction, sadly, is not really SBN, but I recommend you don't fight against SBN because SBN will be destroying you at every corner. So be very careful that you actually help SBN evolve. And don't fight against them. They are so strong with their energy weapons, and the stuff they get later will be super strong. But in the beginning, they seem to be very weak right now. So instead of SBN in the beginning, you should be helping, well, I'd hate to say it, but it's Daydream Cams. Why? Because they gain the Frame Power Armor. And while this armor is not very good against a few things, it's super strong against blunt and cutting damage. As you can see, it has no pierce resistance. So that means if you, let's say, get the armor from Ancom, let's say you wear the... Probably would need, I would say, the pants and the boots to have 18 pierce resistance. You don't need much pierce resistance because the pierce resistance are basically going to affect 9mm weapons, which are basically pistols and SMGs, and 18 resistance is more than enough to keep you safe. It will still hurt a lot sometimes, but it will keep you safe most of the times. So, yeah, it's a massive improvement. I mean, look at this. So, you will have blunt resistance 26 with just two armor pieces, while Ancom will probably need all of the pieces to even get close to that amount. 26, it will need 3 pieces. So, yeah, put SBN a little bit on the burner, but help them out as well. So, Realware, Ancom, SBN, and Daydream Chems are your best friends this wipe. Just mix and match whatever you can, and also keep in mind that you'll have to unlock Percy. It's still the same thing with Percy. I kind of hate it, but there's not much you can do about it. As you can see, my Percy over here has 46... blunt, 44 cut, and the pierce is at the lower just because of the mishmash of armor that he has. We'll get to the equipment a bit later, so let's continue on with the corporations. Now, for my personal let's play, I'll also choose the Church of Revelation. You can also choose it in case you're having problems with the other factions. Instead of Daydream Chems, you can also choose these guys, or instead of SBN. Because they'll give you the Jeff Hammers, all of the cool shotguns, and also a lot of electromagnetic weapons, plus a lot of quasimorphosis reduction items, and as you can see, they also have the calories, they also reduce hypothermia. Heals, Ars. Ars is radiation damage, and radiation damage you really, really hate once you see how bad it is. It's like vodka and stalker. Ars will give you a lot of basic item chips. They have one of the highest chances to give you chips even at 2 tech. At 4 it will be a little harder. I'll also try to kind of grow Core Ward and Civil Resistance. The Civil Resistance are the hardest factions to grow. I don't recommend them, but I'll be using them for my playthrough. So, that's kind of it. So, Realware, Ancom, SBN, and then you have the Daydream Chem. So, these four factions, these four corporations are your best choice right now, in my opinion. But again, they will change as you play the game a little more, and you'll see how they evolve. As for the clones, well, to be honest, in the beginning of the game, you'll struggle a lot, no matter what you do. Now, keep in mind that Victoria Boudica has a 65% accuracy for guns, which is one of the highest in the game. It doesn't have a good pain threshold, but the weapon range plus 2 is definitely a massive help. So, try to use a shotgun and another weapon that kills enemies. We'll speak about this a little later. Percy is still, of course, the best character in the game. Now, as you can see, it's a problem because of his accuracy is so low, but since you'll be using a shotgun, it doesn't really matter most of the times. Shotgun and sniper rifle or other stuff. Now, Isabella is a little better, but it's useless because this is supposed to be a melee character. Just look at the stats. Useless. I'll only show you the ones I have so far. So, you might find another one that is better. Now, Priya Marlon, I don't remember her, probably because I never played with her. But her stats are not bad. Victoria has 115 health, she has 110. Accuracy is not that good, but she has an item capacity of 4. So in case you're doing an easier mission, it might just be worthwhile to take this character, this clone with you in the mission. If you're doing a 1, 2, or maybe even 3 skull mission, you probably want extra item capacity, especially after you die. So if you die and if you want to do an easy mission, definitely choose this character over here. As you will be able to recover from a loss much faster because of the extra inventory space. Jacques, he's the one that has the reduced reload speed. Yes, I don't understand the point of this character. This character is very good in defense missions because in defense missions you don't have enough time to reload. So in case you're wondering what the class specialty is, yeah, it's defense mission. But once you get the vest that has a reload bonus, this character becomes useless as his bonus is. And then you also have Kenzie Yukio, which has a lot of interesting things like the dodge and the accuracy. This has actually become a viable option. So out of all of the ones that I have right now, I think Percy is the first and then Kenzie Yukio will be the second just because of the extreme amounts of dodge that they have. Look at this. And the dodge will actually be always around, I don't know, 25%, just because it will not be affected by a lot of the weight you're carrying. Also, pain threshold is pretty big. Starvation limit is going to be a problem, but not such a big one. Health is going to be another big problem, but the enemies will miss you more or less. Think about it, you actually have a dodge chance that adds on top of the enemy's chance to hit. So if the enemy has a chance to hit you of, I don't know, let's say 75%, and if you have 25% dodge, that will be a... Anyway, just know that is good. In case you're struggling, try with this character, but you lose in terms of looting. Now, what are the gear choices? Now, this is the hard part of the game, because many things have changed. And from what I can see, the best thing to do is kind of mix and match. Now, if you don't get a buffalo backpack, use whatever. And I really recommend you have at least one frame power armor, or let's just say one power armor item, because it increases your stats by a lot. Also, it resists cold, which is a massive bonus. So try to have one or two frame items if you can. Other than that, the arbiter items, like I said, they are pretty good because they also help you against fire and shock, more related to the fire than anything else. The pointsman is just that I don't have anything else better to wear, and the glory is actually pretty good right now because it offers resistance against fire and cold. So if you put that into perspective with Percy, he has a kind of a nice fire and cold resistance. You will not be able to tank a lot of damage, but you will not die from the basic weapons. Plus the beam weapons, he can resist quite well with the current setup I have. What is a beam weapon? The beam weapons are just the laser weapons which no longer do fire damage. As you can see, they do beam damage, so think about that a little bit as well. As for the weapons, like I said, I recommend the electromagnetic stuff. If you can find electromagnetic rifles, apparently they are quite commonly found. I lost two or three of them, and I also found two again. So your first choice will always be a shotgun, either this or the Taiga M or NCM if you can find it, or a better Jeff Hammer. So this is for clearing out trash units, killing the trash units and the robots, and this will be for sniping the heavy armored units. As you can see, this has an accuracy of 108, but this has an accuracy of 85, with the exception that this does 40 damage every time you hit someone. But remember, it's not going to be 40 damage, sometimes it's bigger than 40 damage, I don't know, they should really explain some of these things, but oh well. So this thing has a silencer. I'm not sure if people know this, but it does matter a lot. If you are killing someone at a distance with this thing that has a silencer, it doesn't make any sound. The enemies will rarely hear you. I think all of the electromagnetic weapons have a silencer, so yeah, definitely try out like this. If you find a lot of enemies in an area, just try to kill them with this thing. They'll not even notice what's happening. Also, another option, if you don't have the Enigma Supreme, you can also take the Course VKT, because you'll find a lot of enemies who actually carry it, and you'll find a lot of light ammo for it, which is amazing because it does 22 to 30, one of the most damaging 90mm ammo guns you can find in the early game. Plus, like I said, you don't need a lot of piercing resist. If you have 34 piercing resist, that's enough to negate any type of damage except for the criticals from the guns that will fire at you. So that's why I kind of choose the frame power helmet, and I mean, that's the one I got, but you see the point. Don't need as much pierce armor as you need cut or blunt. You can also replace it with a maximum rifle if you have them, but as you can see, the damage is almost lower than the Enigma. I think they lowered on purpose the damage of the sniper rifles just so they are not so useful anymore. Sadly, heavy ammo is very hard to find, and when you get it, it's not going to be worth it to use the guns that you have. The guns that use heavy ammo are not as good as they used to be. There's also kind of like this intermediary ammo right now, the rifle ammo, which is a lot better, but still, as you can see, the damage output of guns like this is not as good as it used to be, so I cannot use it, I just don't like it. Plus, the energy weapons have low durability, and it's very hard to find ammo for them, so that's why I think I'll just go with the electromagnetic stuff. Condition is 60, condition is 50, so as you can see, this has a lot more condition. Also, the range and accuracy is kind of bad, but yeah, what can you do? Not much you can do in terms of guns either way. Also, the hydro tactical pistol, as you can see, is not really that good because the Corps VKT is just so much better than it in all regards. So, Yeah, sadly, the pistols are kind of very weak at the moment, so that's why I recommend this Enigma Supreme or just another sniper rifle. You can also use one of these things, which is the blaster prototype or whatever else you find. Just note that you're only using it to kill the heavy armored enemies. And the damage is quite nice. Now, what loadout should you have for a mission? Well, basically, the loadout will have to be food, muumuu, sorbent, and then a lot of bandages if you have them or not. I just don't want to make more bandages, especially because now I have the armor situation sorted out. If you don't have the armor situation sorted out, definitely bring nano steams or bandages with you as well. Otherwise, bring anything that adds regeneration because now to heal it's super hard. So let me show you how I used to play when I was playing it very safely. So 2 bags of food, one sorbet. Of course, this will be morphine because we'll be doing a mission with Quasimorphosis. A healing item, just a better healing item, and a few weapon parts because these things will break so fast. Also, I will try to use grenades a lot more, but sadly the grenades are still in a very bad place because of their time to explode, the damage not being that good. Anyway, we'll try to use them more and more. Because the quasi-morphic items will just disintegrate or they'll rot away, so there's not much you can do about it. So look at this, you will actually have regeneration plus 15 for 4 turns, right? Right. But this will heal a lot more things, plus you also will have electric damage and some other things. It's kind of crazy how much the game has changed. Also, you cannot use the Cosmos to reduce quasi-morphosis because it's kind of silly. Nicotine addiction is actually very bad. In the beginning, it doesn't have a lot of debuffs, but then it will start to decrease your accuracy and some other things like max self, and it's super bad. I would not use Cosmos now. I would just use bottles of stuff. Okay, much better. Actually, like I said, I want to loot a lot of stuff and I want to be extra careful. So in a raid, try to bring, let's say, food, sorbet, plenty of ammo. Shotgun ammo is pretty easy to find, light ammo is pretty easy to find, heavy ammo is very hard to find, and rifle ammo is also very hard to find, so there's not much you can, there's not a lot of choices for you to take, so I guess we'll have to stick with this one. Also, Darkcore addiction can be cured by the sorbet, so I guess that's why I like this thing. Think this is a pretty good loadout. Probably we'll end up throwing the grenades, we'll end up drinking stuff, we'll throw all of that as well. So let's play a mission, because that's probably what everyone wants to see. As you can see, I didn't really play a lot of missions with him, but he usually levels up everything almost to the max. And his accuracy is very important, because he basically has no accuracy penalty unless the enemies have a lot of dodge because of the accuracy. He also has a minus chance to receive wounds, so he's actually a lot better fitted for this, for the Scots of Hades than any other classes. You can see this is a 2-star only or 2-skull mission for real wear. Also, the rewards is very weird because I think this is bugged. I don't think we'll get 2,000 out of it. What is the idea? Probably they want it so that if you are fighting a stronger corporation or something, you get more rewards, but I'm not sure if you'll get that many points. I also have problems with trading because it seems like the trading is a little bit busted as well. Usually you can do it like this and this will be 2,000, right? Well, I guess that's another thing I wanted to show you. Some of the trades are really badly, let's say, balanced. As you can see, you can even sell your junk items over here. So Mecta is in Venus, and guess what? This is kind of like the only place you can find to trade stuff with Morphine. So Morphine has become so much more important than it once was. And as you can see, Ancom is doing quite well. So let's trade a few things. Now, I guess you can just use the alcohol, to be honest, even though you have to wait a little bit, food container. I'll also take some water with you because water heals directly. Also take those things with us again. Just taking a few extra things. It will be kind of annoying to reduce quasimorphosis with this. Also, we'll take the cigarettes because this is not such a bad mission to see why I don't like it. You also cure the addictions with the medical kit, the medical units. And you also see why I don't like them. Okay, so let's do the trade and you'll see what why do I don't do this, because as you can see, it's not very good. 3,000 points. I'll get nothing for this. But I mean, seems like the trades are very, very rough to do right now. A lot of times you're just going to get ammo and a fighter backpack, which I don't really want, so I guess you should stack up your items and use them as little as possible so you can save them for the better gear. Shadow pattern. I guess I can maybe use that. But more importantly, I got a few of the better shotguns. So let's compare them with the Baby Jeff Hammer. This is the Baby Jeff Hammer. There are two other versions of it that are much better. As you can see, they only have 12 shots. And these things have 100 durability. 11 to 27. Much better, as you can see. Yeah, let me see the scatter. The scatter is also a little worse for the Jeff Hammer. 3 kilograms, 4 kilograms. So it's also heavier. Range is 4, range is 4. Critical damage is 35. This has a critical damage of 40. So, we have to look at all of the stats. As you can see, we have some good things, some bad things. But yeah, definitely better. Also, the game changes a lot when you find a gladiator or something that reduces reload duration. I can wear that armor, but I just don't have a good defense on my other stuff. So if I, let's say, replace that, I'll be basically defended against everything. I can leave it like this. Where are we? We're in Mecta Orbit. Venus. Venus is not so bad. We're going to be fighting against Stunlight Coven. Looking at the items will kind of give you a brief description of what they'll be attacking you. So I would say it's not worth it to change it for now. So let's just have that armor back. Okay, let's put it there. And I think that's kind of everything I wanted to take. As you can see, we'll have a lot of interesting things to do. Again, I'm just over preparing for this mission to show you how I would normally do it for a harder mission. I can still die. Death is also a possibility over here. So yeah, you have to adapt a little bit more. And I think a lot of people will just give you a lot of bad advice because they say, oh, the game is not hard. The game is very hard because it's unbalanced right now. It's very hard to see what will go. Open container. Definitely take that. Like I said in another video, definitely take all of the containers with you, even though they don't seem impressive. Sometimes it's just better to keep them and don't trade them, as they can give you a lot of cool stuff. See, we already have arrived to the elevator. Also, when you get this cave map, whatever you do, don't waste too much time searching for the next floor. Now, since we're on the second floor, that means we're actually ahead of the difficulty curve a little bit. I assume the elevator will be there. Take all of the loot you can. These guys are quite easy to differentiate. As you can see, most of them will have shotguns and light pistols. It will not be a problem. Also, again, when you find stuff like this, remember they're actually worth disassembling, because you might get more trade points if you disassemble them. You might, let's say, get 3 items out of disassembling, and those items will be worth more than one of these items, but it will be a lot harder to trade them. So I guess you have the bad things, the good things, and like I said, heavy ammo is very hard to find. And you'll never have enough bandages with you anyway. Also, the armor plates are quite worth trading, because you can get them for about 3, I think. You can sell one for 3 points. If you have a stack of armor plate, that could mean about 60 points if you're struggling in the beginning. Try to trade the basic materials as well. I'll not do that because it's boring. Yeah, sadly, this is the way you're supposed to play the game right now. Very time consuming. Also worth noting that even though you will not like these weapons, as you can see, they have their damage buffed, and now they're actually usable. You can use them and they'll do a lot of damage to enemies. But what I recommend you do is actually disassemble them and keep the printed circuit board and the chemtrails to disassemble them in your base in case you want to make a trade for the acid stuff. Assemble that. Sadly, it's so boring. I'll not take the plastic just because I want this to kind of be a show and tell type of mission. Also, I'll take the rubber because I want to do a lot with it. Meaning, this is a good place to get rubber from these units. Yeah, let's disassemble everything. Get another stack of ammo. The pipes are very interesting as well because they are used to make the Jeff hammer. So you might want a stack of them. I don't want your bandage. Try to preserve the acid vats because they are worth a lot of trading points later on. Or if you just want to disassemble them for acid, I don't know. You have to play the game a lot to kind of figure out those trades because it will take me so much time to give you all of the details. I just shown you where the fucking trade is. Yeah. This is dangerous tile, I guess. Well, okay, whatever, we'll just leave it be. You can move on the dangerous tiles, I guess. Doesn't really matter, you can wait, but I don't want to wait. But keep in mind that the reload duration might be a lot bigger for some of the weapons. Let me see where it says the reload duration. 4 action points. This will be a lot less. I mean, the electromagnetic rifle doesn't have any reload period, so that's why it's so good. You just fire it until it gets smashed. I hate you. So you'll never be cut off guard if you have a weapon that doesn't need to be reloaded. Also need a lot of gunpowder. Again, you just need so many things. I also need to take the bottles back with me. Careful, because you'll get wounded a lot more. Once you start killing enemies near the door, just wait, because all of them will come. I'm not joking. You have to wait until all of the enemies come outside. You should never position yourself near the entrance of a door. You have no idea how dangerous that is. Even with their low quality armor, they can still take a lot of damage. That's why we need a tunnel rat. Only one turn to reload, so that means in one turn. Good. I saw him. I'm just getting this for the rubber. That at 94 they can actually spawn with a gun, and that's the main problem. It seems the developers have forgotten about all of the balancing they did beforehand, so the Quasimorph demons should not spawn with guns before 100 Quasimorph forces. Yeah, but what can you do? Just have to spread the love. As you can see, if I didn't have these guns, it would have taken me a much longer time to do it. That's just an air gun. The air guns are dangerous because you can get a wound based on the projectiles that hit you and damage you. So, even though an air gun technically does no damage to you, it can wound you beyond belief. Thermal containers are also nice because you can get a lot of stuff with them. Okay, this would be a good time. As you can see, I'm just trying to empty my inventory a little bit. we can disassemble these things and get some interesting stuff to trade, but again, I'm not going to that particular trade method. Bottom down game, we're not doing anything bad. And this is where it gets tough. As you can see, we still have to get a lot of stuff, even with my kind of like my extended inventory. We still can get a lot of stuff, so also check everybody. Sadly, this is the way the game is meant to be played right now. Check everybody, because they might have some very interesting loot. The elevator, I found it already. Guess it was down here. Usually near these things. Near the container. So I guess that's one way to tell if you're going to be near the elevator or not. It will have containers near it. So, we have done the heavy part of the mission, so now let's just loot. Now, that's a very bad idea. Just wait for them to appear out of nowhere. Also, destroy the door. That's the easiest way to do it. Also, look behind you. Sometimes the enemies will be behind. If they do something like this, use this because it can pierce multiple enemies at the same time. When it wants. Yeah, that's still a bit scary. I guess you can let them fight it out. Okay, and as you can see, that's almost the full durability of this weapon, which is kind of annoying. I barely killed a few enemies with it. And that's why I don't know. It's a lot of work now. Oh, hello. Exactly what I wanted, see what I mean? That alcohol package is probably the best thing you can use. If you can, try to keep the Quasimorph forces below 100, because... Yeah, there's no rhyme or reason to it anymore, you just have to survive. Also, this helmet is very, very good, the glory helmet, but we're not needed right now. Yeah, don't waste too much time looting. Just, you know, disassemble the important stuff and then you can go. 20 rubber, that's enough rubber. At least I can also get cable, aka the wire. Tuna steak, delicious. I haven't experimented too much with the food because you have a lot more food types now, but I don't think it will be worth it anyway. The bottles also stack until 10, so it's a good idea to just have a lot of bottle stuff in your adventure. As you can see, I brought a lot of food just to be sure, but you shouldn't bring this much. I just brought everything that I needed to survive the entire mission in case the worst thing happened. So the worst case scenario. If no enemy has come for us this far, oh wow, we'll be collecting a lot of useful stuff. Yeah, as you can see, morphine is not really that recommended to use, because it's so much better just to sell it. As you can see, 300 for the morphine. You know what? This item over here, it's probably worth... I don't know. Sometimes you need to have 3 or 4 items to be worth 300, like this one that occupied 2 slots. But as you can see, the morphine is still the best trade in the game, whatever you look at it, whatever you do, I don't know. Developers should really balance this stuff out. Yeah, we can also go up there. The enemies also repopulate areas. What I mean about the thermal containers. Let's put that down. The management units are not really worth that much, because I have a lot of them anyway. Laboratory clothes. I want this. This is a set of chemical resistant clothes. I guess we'll be leaving the mission soon anyway, so it doesn't matter. Okay, switch to this weapon. I don't want to break the acid vat. Well, none of them seem to have very good weapons, but again, this is just the beginning of the game and we don't have a lot of enemies. Yeah, it's beginning to be again very dicey. Man, the amount of Quasimorph forces you get from just existing is kind of annoying. There might still be an enemy or two over here. Yeah, I can just throw away one of that if I want. Also, try to disassemble everything so you can see what it gives you, so you can get a better... how should I put it? A better notion of its value. Also, remember that these items are worthless now because they decay in 2 days, so if you want to trade them, just take them from a station where they'll actually accept them. They also increase Quasimorphosis by 100, so... it's going to be worth it anymore. Also very hard to get the weapon parts, as you can see I'm destroying a lot of weapons but barely getting any. I don't think we can get wires from this, so it's kind of pointless to destroy the clothes. Gunbang magazine, I wish I could keep more of them but not possible. So yeah, as you can see it's mostly going to be 90mm and buckshot. The new rifle ammo type 0.42 is not going to be that encountered. Also the sink will have the water. Water is a very good trade. It's a good healing item. You should have a lot of water on you in case you're dying a lot, but also yeah, it's good. It's just good to make, I think you make one of the drinks with that. You need water to make the drinks. Maybe all of the drinks need the water and some other stuff. So it can really get funny, okay? The PMC that sadly has to drink during a mission. We'll go to the final floor and over here we have to destroy one objective. It's still very, very dangerous when you enter a floor because you need to attack from a certain angle. I'm not sure I explained this enough, but... when you enter a new floor, you should be using the silenced weapons if you have any. Also, they reduce the amount of items you can get from the crate, so that's kind of annoying because you barely get anything. See, we are not really noticed by the enemy right now. And the difference between the shotgun and this is massive. Oh wow, that's a lot of items. I'm not sure if I'll complete the entire level, maybe I'll just complete it so you can see what I mean. Construction drones. I think the construction drones are harder to get than the other stuff. Huh. Yeah. This is what I mean by the game sometimes having annoying stuff like this. Let's use the team. Somehow they are surviving the fire with their clothes, with their t-shirts. And now that I'm using the shotgun, as you can see, they are coming in a big squad. I couldn't see the enemy, but the enemy could see me. This will reduce your maximum health. Some of the effects can be really annoying, especially because if you pair the... okay, go full auto. If you pair the effects of max health reduction of the cosmos, cigarettes and some of the other stuff, you really see what I mean. About effects kind of getting out of control. We can also repair this. Even better. I guess I should have used the grenade. I also want to get a lot of energy, so I guess the wire will have to wait. The pistols are not really that good. The chips you can stack all the time, so that can be an option for looting if you like it. Also, try to use up the healing kits if you see them, and if you think you're in danger, because most of the time your health will be very, very low, even if you don't notice it. Because I think only at about 80% fullness do you still heal. And you also get a lot of items that already are unlocked. For whatever reason. Water, I already said. Water is good. Well, I actually had more space for this, but I'm just trying to... Yeah, probably this will be worth it. See? 21 to 34 melee damage. 46. So can someone explain to me how this works? It says melee damage, so it's a police button, but it's probably blunt damage, right? Right. It says it's blunt damage. It's a max damage of 34. My blunt resist is 46, so how does he break again? It can stop a maximum of... I think the armor can stop a maximum of 90% damage, 90%. So 10% of the damage will still pass through the armor. But how does that injure me so fast? So they wanted to balance out the armor, but as you can see, it ended up being more annoying. Because even stuff that shouldn't damage you at all ends up damaging you more than they should. And as you can see, a lot of things that should stack don't stack. Like, these things should definitely stack. What's the deal with that? I mean, they're not so expensive. I guess that's the way the developers wanted to envision the game. This is their vision. Fascinating. Not, I'm not going to play your little game. My bad, I wanted to shoot him, not go near him and hug him. You can see almost all the time you'll have an injury or two. Quasimorphosis is still out of control. Now, think about it, yeah, we have to reduce that. I guess I can let you see the penalties. As you can see, even at the first level, your accuracy is going to be reduced by 15%. So never, ever let it even be 1%. Kill the wounds, that's so scary. Wow, that's... That's what I am trying to tell the developers in a way. There's no way you can survive all of those injuries, and you cannot bandage during a fight, because as soon as you start bandaging, they will come. And only from this angle you can hit the enemies. And as you can see, once you fire the shotgun, everyone knows where you are, and they'll be coming for your blood. And they'll be coming in huge numbers. The point where I think I should just go for the... Look at that, it's red already. I should just go for the mission objective and then hope for the best. Because I came over prepared for this mission, but I'm still somewhat unprepared. I can also not eat Quasimorphosis sensor. I don't see this thing too often. We'll disassemble all of this once we're back at home. And as you can see, we have to use the Cosmos. Gun is amazing. Still, somehow, I only have a few repair items. Yeah, this is not the game where you spend a lot of time fighting, because you'll be out of ammo and the supplies very, very fast. Can I also just say, I think this was a Tuscan mission, if I... What was that, if I remember correctly? Now we regenerate 1 HP per turn. Okay, let's repair. It's just so much better to use the shotgun, because apparently the shotgun will negate some of the accuracy problems. Simply because if it flies towards the target, it will reach the target at some point. Also, disassemble the Dr. Jones, you might get some interesting items out of it, like first aid kits, naloxone. Sadly, I don't have enough space to take them. Yeah, I think the military kits are better than the... yeah. Nation is 20. The military first aid kits are better than the first aid kits entirely. So try to stack them if you can. Okay, reload. Just go for the item. Mission completed, evacuation. Still they injure me, and two times. Yeah, I'm still not giving up, I want to loot a lot of stuff. As you can see, the enemies don't really have a lot of useful things. We barely saw a fighter backpack, I barely see fighter... oh wow, look at that. My current satiety or my metabolism, where do I see it? Over here, yeah. Satiety drain is plus 8 calories, plus whatever this is costing, so that's 10 calories per turn. So, as you can imagine, that will rise very, very, very fast. And I had 20 frags, and I was down to 10. Eh, sadly, this is the way the game has to be played right now. Fill up on food and let's go to the next area. Loot some more, because if you don't loot in the easy missions, you have no chance of doing the hard missions. I cannot express how much you need the loot. Be careful, because sometimes the robots will come with a pick hammer at you. That's not going to be fun at all. I wonder what the point of having the sang is. Yes, it heals a lot of stuff. As you can see, it's active for a lot of turns, but it increases Quasimorphosis by quite a bit. Well, I guess it's not that bad right now. Let's use another Cosmos, just because I want to yeah, look at this. Maximum health minus 5. You'll see how much the debuffs increase over time. So look at their vest and their backpacks, you might find some interesting stuff. What's that weird noise? Am I puking or something? This is because they hit us in the stomach, we might be losing more food than normally are, or... I guess that's what it's trying to tell me, really? What happens when you hear the puking sound? Let's look at the calories. Yeah, good luck with that. Still very risky, I should probably leave. Just imagine I was leaving. Still a lot of enemies, so as you can see, you basically have no chance of filling through the food and other items just because your food will go down so fast because of other effects. I don't think the developers really mentioned this too much. It's kind of like a shadow nod to healing because you don't heal as much from the food. But as you can see, it's always worth staying. We need this as well for the whiskey, but we just don't have room for it right now. Okay, but we don't have any water. Okay, Okay, what is broken? The stomach. It doesn't explain what it does. It should explain what it does when it pukes. Hey, a nice lollipop. You cannot eat it because your stomach is damaged. Even Tarkov lets you eat when your stomach is damaged. Now, let me look at this. I will not be needing those things again because we'll be leaving anyway. This is not so important, but as you can see, when you disassemble it, you get a lot of items. So again, just look at how many items you get. So that's why it's so important to get the items. So the debuff might seem minor in the beginning, but look at this. I guess we still had one more room to finish to search, but I'm not going to risk it. This has already been a 15-minute mission. And dying right now would be terrible. I also forgot where I left my food, so maybe if I would have remembered where I put my food. It's not worth it to risk it for the biscuit. I'm so curious what's in that room, but yeah, we're all almost out of food and we're going to puke and probably lose food as well. This was the best case scenario for a mission. I had a lot of items with me. I was over prepared and ready to fight, and guess what? We barely made it out alive. I mean, we didn't really have a chance to die, but we still didn't get a lot of chances to get items. Life on this elite, that's not that good. Percy, I already have Percy. I guess it's good. This submachine is good, but it's kind of hard to get ammo for it. I'm actually pretty satisfied with the items we got. Okay, we'll put that over there so I don't see it. Huh. Yeah. Best case scenario. This is the best you can hope for. And guess what? Now you have to choose another mission. And now the mission is wow. Oh man, 820. That's not going to be fun. You can see they're fighting against each other right now. Ancom. Oh. This will probably be my next mission. Beneficiary will be Ancom. It's a free skull mission. The reward is quite small, so not really worth it. That's another problem, another big problem. They're trying to attack Mars in 18 days. I guess we can try to go on Mars to resolve the issue. The moon, but this is a very hard mission. I wouldn't do it. You see the rewards are all over the place. The rewards don't reflect the dangerous missions. RTI on Mars. I'll probably not have enough time to go there, but we'll go there anyway. As you can see, having the Jeff Hammer so you can craft in the beginning is a massive boost. Oh wait. I should have traded more of my... I guess I could have done it. Also keep in mind when you disassemble this, you'll get a lot of acid, which can be traded for good money. If you can sell acid for free a piece, that's exactly how much you'd get. There's probably one of the things that can sell for a lot of money as well, I don't know. I guess it's just a lot of... trial and error. Disassemble all of that, and now we can just make a lot of morphine so we can trade it here. Problem is that I don't really need anything from there anymore. We can just leave it and come back later when we get more levels to the corporations. I think it was SBN. Yeah. Yeah, let's check again that. Or no, it was Ancom. Oh, it was Ancom. I don't really want a shadow set, to be honest. I am just waiting for them to go to the next tech level so I can get more items. I think 2 Taigas NCM will be enough for now, so yeah, definitely keep some items in reserve to trade for later. Also, you can trade super fast by using this button in case you have anything, but don't do it like that. Most of the times you lose items or currencies. I guess that's all of the tips I have for now. And as you can see, I don't know, there's a big problem with the game. It shouldn't be this hard to simply play the game and advance in the game. Oh well, I guess this was kind of like an extended tutorial of how the game really is right now and how careful you should be with it. See you next time. Bye bye.